Hello to all the students. Today we will be talking about the septic tank, disposal of the effluent from the septic tank, and somewhat regarding amorph tank. Okay, now what is first of all septic tank? A septic tank may be defined as a primary sedimentation tank with a longer detention period. Usually the detention period is about 12 to 36 hours, as against 2 hours for ordinary sedimentation tank. And also the septic tank has an extra provision for digestion of the settled sludge. Since the digestion of the settled sludge is carried out by anaerobic decomposition process, the septic tank unit is generally classified under the units which work on the principle of anaerobic decomposition. Okay, so it is a tank, actually like a sedimentation tank only, but because we know that the normal sedimentation tank has detention period of 2 hours, here septic tank has more than 2 hours, usually 12 to 36 hours. And plus, since for so much time the effluent is stored in that septic tank, anaerobic digestion takes place, so space for sludge decomposition is also maintained in the septic tank. Okay, now a septic tank is thus a horizontal continuous flow type of sedimentation tank, okay, directly admitting raw sewage and removing about 60 to 70% of dissolved matter from it. The effluent from such a tank will be sufficiently foul in nature and will have to be disposed of either for subsurface irrigation or in soak pits or to be treated in trickling filter, etc., which we will be discussing further. Okay. Then the sludge that will be settled at the bottom of the tank and the oil and greasy matter rising at the top surface of the sewage, that is called the scum, are allowed to remain in a tank for a period of several months. Okay, so several months we say because we know the septic tanks where usually we see in the apartments, it is not frequently clean. It is hardly clean in once in a year, once in 6 months, or once in 3 years. For so several months, the sludge and the scum layer, okay, that is stored in that particular septic tank. Okay, now since they are stored for several months, during this period, it is decomposed by the anaerobic bacteria to form gases and liquids by the process of sludge digestion. Okay, the resultant sludge so obtained will subsequently be much less than that obtained in ordinary settling tank in terms of its quantity. Okay, the digested sludge from the tank is periodically at an interval of 6 to 12 months or not exceeding 3 years is removed and taken to a nearby sump from where it may be pumped up to the ground and disposed of in a sanitary manner, preferably after drying it. Okay, so like I said, the septic tank is not clean always. It is clean once in 6 months or once in 2 years, or maximum limit is 3 years, and after which the sludge is removed from that tank. Okay, now I'll show you the diagram of how the septic tank looks so you can get the construction details of it. Now, this is a schematic diagram of how the septic tank looks. Okay, I'll also show you a 3D view of it. See, this is how your septic tank looks. It has two chambers, which is called the inlet chamber and the outlet chamber. Why that is, the most of the sludge gets settles in this inlet chamber, and the baffle walls are provided from which only the sewage effluent will pass through this chamber to this chamber and from where outside. Okay, and this is the scum layer, and this extra part is nothing but the freeboard, what we say. Okay, now going to the construction details, the plan and the section are already given in this diagram. Okay, the tank is designed to prevent direct currents between the tank inlet and the outlet. Okay, so therefore this ensures effective sedimentation and is achieved by using T-shaped pipes. Okay, so that there is no direct entry of the sewage into the septic tank. So T-shaped pipes are provided with submerged ends at inlet and outlet. Okay, then the tank is generally covered at top with RCC slab. Manhole covers are provided in the top slab so as to permit inspection and maintenance. Okay, then sometimes chairs or cast iron pipes may also be provided to go into the tank if needed. Cast iron steps, sorry. The RCC cover prevents the escape of foul gases and odors from the tank onto the ground and prevents the chances of accident due to falling of children or animals and prevents wind agitation, thus keeping the sewage warm and helping in bacterial activity, which is what we want. Okay. The foul gases produced by the anaerobic decomposition of the deposited sludge are separately removed through a vent pipe projecting sufficiently high above the ground so as not to cause any damage or any nuisance to the neighboring areas. Okay, so this cover usually acts like a manhole cover. Okay, sometimes the steps are provided so that inspection could be done manually. Okay, then. This is how your septic tank looks like. This is the inlet chamber. This is the outlet chamber. Okay, sludge deposition part is here. Okay, a slope is given so that sludge could be accumulated easily. Okay, and this is your plan. Then, next, going to design consideration, I would suggest you people to write down this design considerations because it would be useful while solving the numericals. Okay, now a septic tank should be capable of storing the sewage flow. Okay, during the detention period and an additional volume of sludge for 6 months to 3 years depending upon the periodicity of cleaning. Okay, so when you decide the capacity or what you can say is the volume of the septic tank, it is nothing but the volume required to store the sewage for a particular detention time. We know what is detention time. Detention time is a time for which the sewage is stored in that tank. Usually, at the start of the septic tank introduction, I said that the detention time of the septic tank is more than normal sedimentation tank and is usually 12 to 36 hours. Okay, so whatever the time period is, till that time, how much quantity of the sewage is accumulated and plus amount of sludge which is collected, and that collection will depend upon the period of cleaning. For example, the period of cleaning of the septic tank is 6 months. The amount of sludge that is accumulated in that 6 months, that volume plus effluent, or we can say the sewage which is collected for a particular detention period. Both these volumes will give me the volume of my or capacity of my septic tank. Okay. Then what else you need to know is if water closets are only connected to the septic tank, the sewage flow is usually 40 to 70 liters per capita per day. For 8 to 10%, it comes at around 1400 liters, which is the minimum capacity of septic tank. Now, water closet and sewage, if both the things are connected to the septic tank, the sewage flow is 90 to 150 liters per capita per day. For 8 to 10%, it is around 2 to 50 liters, which is minimum capacity of septic tank. Then, rate of accumulation of sludge. How much sludge is accumulated in a particular year by a particular person is 30 liters. This is very useful in deciding the volume of the sludge deposited. Okay, so it is 30 liters per person per year, rate of accumulation of sludge. Freeboard to in the tank is usually around 0.3 to 0.5 liter. Then the inlet and outlet baffles. Okay. Then extended up to 20 to 22 centimeter above the top sewage line. Okay, now I'll show you this. 20 centimeter, it is extended above the top sewage line. This is also around 20 centimeter above the top sewage line. Okay, then at least 7.5 centimeter below the top covering slab. Okay, so it has to be below. See, I'll show you again in the diagram. This 5 to 7.5 centimeter, which is shown. So it has to be below the top cover slab around 5 to 7.5 centimeter. Then inlet penetrating level, that is 30 centimeter below the top sewage line. Okay, 30 centimeter. And outlet penetrating level, it has to be 40% of the depth of sewage. This is 40% of the depth of sewage. Now, more design considerations are the detention period. Detention period is commonly adopted as 24 hours. For easy calculation, you can take it as 24 hours or whatever is given in the question, you'll have to take that. Then length to width ratio is L is equal to twice B or thrice B you can take. Then width, that is B, should not be less than 90 centimeter, and depth can be assumed between 1.2 to 1.8 meter. Okay. Now, we will go through a problem or related to the septic tank.